here, we see, again, move or copy. So we can switch this to move or copy, and we can move it around using the center point. Let's try moving it. So now we've moved our arc. Next, we have the flip button. When you click the flip button, you're going to get the opposite solution, or the complement of the arc.
Go to the Surfaces tab and go to Surfaces from Solids. Our active level is number 7. This is our new machining surfaces. From here, I'm going to do a shift click on any blue surface, and that's going to select all of those. You can deselect the gear, but let's leave the center selected because we will need that for later.
We're going to find the tool under wireframe, in the lines group, under line closest. We'll find line normal to grid. So the first thing we need to select is the surfaces, solid faces, or meshes that we want to use this on. This also works on open sheet bodies. So here I actually have a surface and some open sheet body. So I'm going to select this curve here, and then I'm also going to select this curve here. Notice that I did select them in the same direction, and that's kind of important because the direction that you select them has a lot to do with the way that it's averaged. You can do some experiments on your own with selecting them in different directions, and you'll see the results change quite a bit. So after selecting those two, I'll hit the green check. And now we have this great center line that is the average of the two outside curves. So let's take this a step further. So starting in 2022, nodes are actually associative entities that we can use for chaining for certain things. For example, we can chain a simple contour to do some etching right on those letters without having to break them into any geometry. So if we go into our geometry for this contour operation, I'm going to right click file types. With all those selected, let's hit open, and we'll get all of our parts here. I'm going to leave the settings at default for merge file levels and none of these settings turned on. Let's move the first set of these into position. So let's start with the coupler. I think that the align tool would work well here, so we'll use align. I'll choose the bottom face here, and then the face here. And that's going to snap it right here. And none of this is indicated in the solid history. This is a dumb solid body, nothing else to it. So let's use add history to add in some information. We're going to go to add history. And we have several options we can choose from. We're going to start with the operation
in this
type.
Video, we'll learn how to use the manual option inside of add history for whole operations.
You may end up with a part that's very complicated, something like this. If we go to a section view of this part in the second view sheet, you'll see what I mean. We have a lot of intersecting holes. We have holes that have a lot of different diameters, and this can actually cause issues for the standard all holes option. I'm going to show you a couple tips and tricks for these really complicated holes and also show you how to use these.
As soon as I press the enter key, the window will close and the wireframe entities will be moved. My screen is now blank and there are zero entities on level 5. I'll make level 4 the active level, and the two parallels can now be seen. At this point, I have three levels with no geometry, so I'll place my mouse over level 100 and right click.